Hello dear students, let us see today chapter number 5, The Snake and the Mirror from your book Beehive. Today I am going to give you the background of the story. The interesting twists and turns in the stories you are going to find out while you read it, okay. So just in general I am going to tell you what we have in this story. This story is all about a homeopathic doctor during his early career days. Now, the narrator of this story is the doctor himself, where he narrates this story to some individuals. Now, in this story, the doctor tells us that he lived in a small rented room during his early career days. He was struggling at that time in order to make a living. Furthermore, the tiles of the room were supported by gables, which in turn were supported by the beam. So this you find, that is the moment the story starts, that when you read it, you will get the description of the room, that it was not, not something which was very grand in nature. A room where you can just stay. So the room was supported by gables, which in turn were supported by the beam. Moreover, rats were roaming all over the room and there was no electricity supply. Hence, the room was in a dire state, demanding repair, maintenance. Now, in the doctor's story, it was the summer season going on and it was night. So the doctor came back to his room after finishing his meal at a restaurant. The room was certainly dark due to lack of electricity. As such, the doctor made use of a kerosene lamp to lighten up his room. And the doctor also took off his coat and shirt. You can, when you read the story, you will find about the belongings of the doctor, that is the kind of things he carried in his bag. So there were two windows in the room that were opened by him. After sitting on a chair, the doctor took a medical book to read. Now, on the table, there was a large mirror and a lamp. Due to the immense summer heat, it was too hot for the doctor to sleep. So he began to gaze in the mirror and became lost in admiring himself. Now, when he was admiring himself, a desire came in him to look more presentable, because he was a doctor, so he should look presentable, and on top of that he was a bachelor. So gradually there was a shifting of his thoughts from self-admiration to future marriage. So in a very funny way, the description is given that all sorts of imaginations that were coming in his mind, that you can read, that how he was self-admiring himself and what were his future planning, what kind of a wife he wanted in his life. So the doctor thought of marrying a rich doctor who was rich and fat, and why he wanted to marry a woman who should be a doctor and she should be rich and fat. So the reasons you can find out from the story itself. So the doctor didn't pay much attention to the sudden silence and the scampering from the rats came to a halt. Now, just at that moment, there was a sound of something falling, but the doctor was slow to react because he was totally immersed in his self-admiration. Now, by the time he had a look, there was a snake wriggling on the back of the chair. Soon the snake coiled on the left arm of the doctor. The snake was merely inches away from his face, so consequently the doctor went into a deep shock and became like a statue. At this moment, the doctor felt the presence of God. It seems that the snake was like a punishment from God to the doctor due to his being too arrogant and lost in self-admiration. Soon he came to the realization that he was a mere human being and he should not boast. and also he thought himself to be very stupid. Now, at this realization of his true value or true worth, whatever you call it, so the snake left the doctor and moved towards the mirror. Just at that moment, the doctor silently escaped and his life was saved. So how he saved, where did he go, how he spent his night, there's everything you are going to see in the story. So after the conclusion of the doctor's narrative, some interested listeners asked him some questions related to the story, and the questions are quite interesting. Okay, let me read out the section where his listeners ask him that that what happened at the end of the story. The next morning when he came, he found that all his belongings were gone. And interestingly, one of the listeners asked him the question that did he get his life partner the way he imagined? So what did he answer that you are going to see the moment you read that you will get it the moment you read the story? It's very easy to understand. But very importantly, you have to be very careful while reading the story in order to have all the sequence of events right. Okay? And thereafter, I'll be giving you certain exercises based upon your comprehension. So the story is by Vaiko Muhammad Bashir, a very interesting one. Read it, you will enjoy it. Okay? Thank you.